On this Inauguration Day, power and wealth mingled with the powerless and poor without prejudice in this room. Among them, the Brown family of Atlanta.
It's a new day, a new era, new beginning for America.
Talisha Brown, husband Kenny, and their boys were on top of the world today, certainly up high, watching the parade as it passed by 12 stories below on Pennsylvania Avenue. Their front row to history was thanks to Virginia multimillionaire Earl Stafford and his nonprofit foundation dedicated to the disadvantaged. It was a pricey proposition. $1 million for 300 bedrooms at a downtown hotel and one of the best views in town.
Yeah, this is an outstanding view.
But for this son of a Baptist minister, bringing more than 300 homeless, terminally ill, and veterans from around the country to the inauguration was divine inspiration.
That's what this is really about, that somehow that we become aware that we are, in fact, our brother's keeper.
For the Browns, it opened a fantasy world far removed from their struggles back home.
It's like maybe one step away from actually being on the streets and nowhere to go.
Talisha works in a bookstore. Kenny, a chef, lost yet another job last week. They live in an interfaith shelter for families. They were going to celebrate the inauguration in their tiny apartment.
It's cool that, you know, that somebody was thinking about the little people.
Instead, they'll wear gowns and tuxes, all donated to the People's Inaugural Ball tonight.
Not a lot of people get the opportunity to see the new president, and plus he's African American and the first.
So help me God.
Congratulations, Mr. President.
And they're taking their new president's promises to heart.
Maybe my children will see him, look at him, and want to do something different than they decide, than they wanted to do before now.
What does this all mean to you about your future?
It's bright. You can't go anywhere but up from here.
They're a family finding hope again.
Of course.
Thalia Asuras, CBS News, Washington.